Did you know that low blood sugar or hypoglycemia can be just as dangerous as high blood sugar? While many focus on high blood sugar and its severe consequences, such as kidney failure and nerve damage, low blood sugar poses unique risks, including confusion, fainting, and even life-threatening complications. In today's video, I'm going to be walking you through 10 warning signs that you have reactive hypoglycemia. And these are signs that you should never ignore. I'm going to explain what causes reactive hypoglycemia and give you actionable steps to reverse it. Now, let's start off by talking about what hypoglycemia is and what reactive hypoglycemia is specifically. But if you want to skip ahead to the warning signs, I'm going to have timestamps on the progress bar. Hypoglycemia occurs when your blood sugar levels drop below what your body needs to function properly. Generally, this means blood glucose levels below 70 milligrams per deciliter, or 3.9 millimoles per liter, although symptoms can vary between individuals. Now, there are severe cases where blood sugar drops below 54 milligrams per deciliter, or 3.0 millimoles per liter, and these require immediate attention. Now, there are two types of hypoglycemia, reactive and non-reactive. Reactive hypoglycemia occurs within a few hours of eating. It is often due to an excessive insulin response. And non-reactive hypoglycemia is unrelated to food and caused by other factors such as certain medications, excessive alcohol consumption, or underlying health conditions like kidney, heart, or liver issues. In today's video, we're going to be focusing on reactive hypoglycemia, and this can be tricky to diagnose and even trickier to manage. But there is a solution, so don't worry, and we'll get to that at the end. But first, let's get into the symptoms. The first is a rapid heartbeat, and this is one of the earliest signs of hypoglycemia, a rapid or irregular heartbeat. When your blood sugar drops, your body releases adrenaline to compensate, which can cause your heart rate to spike. So if you frequently notice your heart is racing after a meal, this is a sign you're experiencing reactive hypoglycemia. The next one is becoming shaky or trembling. Low blood sugar triggers the release of stress hormones like adrenaline, which we just spoke about. And this can lead to physical symptoms such as shaking or trembling. This one is very common. A lot of people with reactive hypoglycemia will feel really jittery after they eat. And this is why. The third sign is sweating, particularly cold sweats. This is your body's way of responding to the adrenaline surge that's caused by low blood sugar. Number four is anxiety. Hypoglycemia can cause sudden bouts of anxiety or feeling of impending doom. This is due to the central nervous system's response to the drop in blood sugar and the flood of stress hormones that follow. Number five, blurred vision. Now, your brain is particularly sensitive to drops in blood sugar, and this can manifest as changes in your vision. Unlike high blood sugar, which damages the eye itself, blurred vision from hypoglycemia is temporary and resolves when your blood sugar normalizes. Number six, confusion. And again, this comes back to the brain because low blood sugar can impair brain function. This can lead to confusion or difficulty thinking clearly. You might feel disoriented or forgetful, and this can be especially concerning if it happens frequently. Number seven, irritability. This one is very common. I'm sure you've heard of the term hangry before. Low blood sugar can significantly affect your mood, making you irritable or overly emotional. Number eight, trouble concentrating. Again, back to the brain. Low blood sugar can make it very, very hard to focus. So if you've just eaten and you can't seem to get your mind straight, this could be why. Number nine is extreme hunger. Feeling ravenous shortly after eating is a hallmark sign of reactive hypoglycemia. This happens because your body's insulin response removes too much glucose from your bloodstream, leaving your cells starving for energy. And number 10 is headaches. Low blood sugar can lead to headaches due to the brain's sensitivity to glucose fluctuations. So headaches after a meal, it could be reactive hypoglycemia. Okay, but what causes reactive hypoglycemia? It doesn't really make sense because you've just eaten, the energy is there. Why is your blood sugar dropping so low afterwards? Well, we typically see reactive hypoglycemia after a high carbohydrate meal. And here's why it happens. It's because your body is releasing too much insulin in response to that meal, causing your blood sugar levels to plummet. And this is an early sign of insulin resistance. Because with insulin resistance, you have a mismatch between your blood sugar and your insulin levels. And this can result in low blood sugar after eating, despite adequate glucose being present. It basically comes down to the fact that you're insulin resistant and your metabolism is not functioning optimally. The good news is there is a way to reverse it. So let's get into it. The first thing you're going to want to do is reduce carbohydrates. And this might sound counterintuitive because I know if your blood sugar drops and you want to bring it back up, then eating carbs might sound like the solution. but it is the overconsumption of carbohydrates in general that has gotten you into this mess. Carbohydrates have the most significant impact on blood sugar and insulin levels. By reducing your carb intake and focusing on whole, unprocessed food that is rich in protein and fat, you stabilize your blood sugar. When your blood sugar is more stable after eating, then you don't have a spike, which comes with the drop. So focus your meals around high protein foods, particularly animal protein. Add some non-starchy vegetables and low sugar fruit. And don't be afraid of healthy fat. The next thing you can do is to avoid eating carbohydrates in isolation. So a lot of people, they will reach for something like a banana on its own. But when you eat it on its own, because it is almost entirely made up of carbohydrates, it's broken down rapidly, the sugar enters the bloodstream rapidly, and there's a spike. But if you pair your carbs with protein and fat, this slows down digestion and the spike is more gradual. Another thing that can make a difference is the order in which you eat your food. And in particular, eating your carbohydrates at the end. If you eat protein, fat, and fiber first before the starchy portion of your meal, again, this slows down digestion, there's less of a spike, and less of a crash. I've been running some continuous glucose monitor tests on my channel. I've been uploading them into a playlist, which I'll link above. One of the tests I did recently was I ate rice on its own, and then I ate a chicken breast before the rice, and then another day I ate a chicken breast after the rice. Here's what happened to my blood sugar when I ate the rice on its own, and then when I ate the chicken first. So you can see that the protein had a significant impact. The next thing you can do is to incorporate some intermittent fasting into your routine. Intermittent fasting can improve insulin sensitivity by giving your body time to regulate blood sugar levels without constant food intake. Start with a 12-hour fasting window and slowly increase it to 16 hours if that feels manageable. Intermittent fasting is extremely beneficial for insulin sensitivity. So even if you can only do 12 hours, but you can do it consistently, this will make a big difference. And finally, if you can, you want to monitor your blood sugar. If you suspect that you have reactive hypoglycemia, consider using a glucose monitor to track your blood sugar levels throughout the day. This can help you to identify patterns and make necessary adjustments to your lifestyle. Managing reactive hypoglycemia can seem difficult, but understanding the warning signs and the causes is the first step to managing it effectively. So be smart about your carbs, don't eat carbs naked, try intermittent fasting. The gist of it is you want to avoid blood sugar spikes, because if you don't have the spikes, you're not going to have the crashes. Now, I want to hear from you guys before you go. Let me know if you experience reactive hypoglycemia, or maybe you experienced it in the past. Was there anything you did that helped? I love hearing from you guys. I love hearing what worked and what didn't work for you. So let me know down below. Thanks guys for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.